This is The Final Word.
It's time now for The Final Word. Tim, start us off.
This is for all the juju bots on Twitter. Look, if your favorite player came back to Pittsburgh and you're happy, I'm happy for you. It's going to give me another year of material. But don't make this into something that it isn't. This wasn't Juju coming back to Pittsburgh because he loves Pittsburgh so much and he just wanted to stay. This isn't Juju being a business genius and taking an $8 million deal now because there's going to be a better cap situation next year. He took the best offer available, period. And Kenny Golladay got money and Curtis Samuel got money and he didn't get a multi-year deal. Just don't morph the facts, please.
Dan, your final word?
You know, the Pirates are actually having a pretty good spring, and that goes beyond their 500 record. They've pitched and hit at above the major league average over all 30 teams. But I'm here to tell you, this stuff won't mean anything if Mitch Keller doesn't get it turned around. And yes, it's only been a handful of innings, but he's gotten rocked for 12 runs. He's supposed to be the guy who leads the rotation. He's easily the guy in the rotation with the most talent. That matters not only for 2021, but beyond that. And so far, what we've seen from him has looked a little bit too much like what we've seen from him in the majors over the first two seasons that he's been around. And that's scary stuff for someone who was a top 10 prospect in all of baseball.
Mark, your final word.
The Steelers used to be sacred. They used to do things different and better. Not just a team of six Super Bowl championships, but a team of great players, and beyond that, great men. Men like Troy Polamalu, Mel Blount, Rocky Blyer. Juju Smith-Schuster celebrated his new contract by going on TikTok and gyrating in his underwear, including a scene where he was sitting on a toilet bowl with the lid down, gyrating. We have lost the era when the Steelers were classy. We have lost the era when the Steelers were special. We are now firmly in the era of dance, clown, dance.
And tonight, my final word. There's a lot of issues with the NCAA, but what happened this week with the absolute disparity between the men's and women's basketball tournaments, from the weight rooms to the swag bags, is completely inexcusable. The NCAA will highlight women when it fits their narrative, but when it comes to the biggest stage of these athletes' lives, they provide six sets of dumbbells, yoga mats, and one stationary bike for 64 teams. And then they have the audacity to tweet a picture of the new weight room after being scrutinized on every single level with the caption, "Let's go." Do better, NCAA. Do better. Thanks so much for joining us. Have a great night.